Good morning, children. Sai Ram. How are you all? I hope you all are fit and fine. So, children, today we will going to do a revision of chapters from your science book. Okay. So today we are going to do revision. Okay. So this video is a revision video. Okay, children. So chapter first is eating habits of animals. Okay, eating habits of animals. Okay, so chapter first is eating habits of animals. So children, this chapter, we have already discussed this chapter, right? I hope you all remember. Now we will do a quick revision of this chapter, that is eating habits of animals. As I have told you, children, that every animal has different kinds of eating habit, and according to that they have different types of teeth, right? And they are categorized in different categories, right, children? So we will discuss exercise. Okay, so choose the correct option. First, which of these animals is a carnivore? First, you should know what is carnivore. Carnivores is animal which eat only flesh of other animal, or which eat other animal. That animal is known as carnivorous animal. So which of these animal is a carnivore, children? First option is horse, deer, lion, giraffe. From these four, which animal is a carnivore animal? Yes, lion is a carnivorous animal, because lion eat only flesh of other animal, okay? Or you can say eat other animal. Horse, deer and giraffe are not carnivorous animal. Only lion is a carnivore animal. Second, all food chains start with, now children, what is food chain? Food chain is a kind of cycle, right? Food chain is a kind of cycle which balance the whole ecosystem, right? Food chain is kind of a cycle which balances the whole ecosystem. Okay, that means each and every animal is dependent on each other. Okay, each and every animals are dependent on each other. So food chain start with carnivores, plants, omnivores or herbivores. Food chain always, or you can say mostly, start with plants. What are these? I have told you, plants are what, children? Producer. Plant is a producer. Okay, plant is a producer. So all food chains start with plants. Mostly you can say start with plants. So plant is a producer. After that, plant, then deer, like this food chain starts. So it is a kind of cycle which balances the ecosystem. So this food chain helps in balancing the ecosystem. Third one, what kind of front teeth do herbivore have? What is herbivore, children? Herb means plants, right? So what kind of front teeth do herbivores have? So herbivores are the animals which eat only plants, so question is, what kind of front teeth do herbivores have? So right, herbivores are animals which eat only plants. So as I have told you that different animals have different kinds of eating habits, and according to that they are categorized in different categories or different terms. Carnivores are the animals which eat only flesh of other animals, right? So they are carnivores animal. Herbivores are those which eat only plant. So what kind of teeth do they have? What kind of front teeth do they have? So they have sharp and broad teeth. Okay, they have sharp and broad teeth. So herbivores mostly herbivore animals, or you can say herbivores animal have sharp and broad teeth. Okay, fourth one, which of these animals chews the cud? So children, have you seen cow or buffalo? Every time they are chewing. Okay, they are chewing. Now what do they chew every time? When the time they are not eating anything, what do they chew every time? Their mouth is every time working. Okay, they chew every time. Why? Because what happened? These animals, cow, buffalo, what they do? When they do grazing means eating plants. So when they eat the plant, they do not chew the plant while eating. What do? They directly gulp it down to their stomach. Okay, they don't chew. They directly gulp it down. Okay, they directly consume it without chewing. And after some time, what they do? They just took it back in their mouth and they start chewing. So that is chewing the cud. So which of these animals chews the cud, children? Yes, cow. Cow is the animal which chews the cud. Okay, which chews the cud. That means when they consume or when they graze or when they eat the grass, they do not chew the grass. What they do? They gulp it down. And then they bring it back to their mouth and they start chewing it slowly. Okay, that is chewing the cud. Fifth one, which of these animal uses teeth to tear its food? Which animal uses teeth to tear its food? Does mosquito tear the food? No. Butterfly? Snake? No. Then which option is left? Dog. That means dog is the animal which uses teeth to tear its food. You all know that dog is carnivores or herbivore animal, right? So dog uses teeth to tear its food. Now next, name an animal that has these mouth parts. You have to see the mouth parts and you have to name animal which animal has these mouth parts. First, sharp and broad front teeth. Which kind of animal have sharp and broad front teeth? Yes, herbivore animal has a sharp and broad front teeth, right? You can write cow, buffalo, horse, deer. Okay, then long, sharp and pointed teeth. Which animal has long, sharp and pointed teeth? Animals. Which animals? Yes, carnivores. Carnivore animal eat the flesh of other animals. So they have long, sharp and pointed teeth which help them to tear the flesh. So you can write lion, tiger, etc. Okay. Then C, a long and sticky tongue. Which animal has a long and sticky tongue? Yes, frog. Frog has long and sticky tongue. Long and sticky tongue. Then a sharp and hollow tube to drink blood. Which animal suck the blood? Yes, mosquito. Which animal? Mosquito. Right, mosquito. Mosquito has a very sharp and hollow tube. They just sting in the skin and they suck the blood. Then last, a long and hollow tube to drink nectar. Which animal has, or insect you can say, which has a long and hollow tube to drink nectar? Yes, butterfly. Right, nectar is the juice which they suck from the flowers. Okay, so butterfly has long and hollow tube to drink nectar. So now chapter 1st revision is done. Now we will begin with chapter 2. So chapter 2 is, what are things made of? Different things are made from different kinds of things, right? So what are things made of? As I have told you that plastics आर मेड ऑफ डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ थिंग, मिरर्स, ग्लास आर मेड ऑफ डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ थिंग, क्लोथ्स आर मेड ऑफ डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ थिंग. सो वट आर थिंग्स मेड ऑफ? सो फर्स्ट चूज द करेक्ट ऑप्शन. फर्स्ट वी गेट लाइनन फ्रॉम चिल्ड्रेन. वेट, यस, वी गेट लाइनन फ्रॉम, लाइनन इज अ काइंड ऑफ क्लोथ, ओके, which gets dry very easily and it absorbs the sweat also. So linen is a kind of cloth which is suitable for wearing during summer season, okay. It gets very dry, okay, it gets dry very easily, even faster than cotton clothes. So we get linen from sheep, flax, bamboo, petroleum. We get linen from flax plant. Flax is a kind of a plant, okay. So we get linen from flax plant. Second, which of these materials do we get from animals? Which material do we get from animals, children? Wool, cotton, jute, linen. Which material do we get from animals? Yes, wool. Wool we get from animals like sheep. Right, wool we get from animals like sheep. Cotton we get from cotton plant. Jute we get from jute plant. And linen we get from flax plant. So wool is the material we get from animal. Third one, we make glass from animals, plants, sand, petroleum. We make glass from sand. Okay, we make glass from sand. Fourth, which of these is a metal, children? Copper, flax, timber, rubber. Flax is a plant, timber is also a plant, and rubber is also a plant. So which of these is a metal? Copper is a metal. Fifth, which of these things is not made from materials dug out from the earth? Which of these things is not made from materials dug out from the earth? Petrol, plastic, diesel, linen. So linen we get from flax plant. So which of these things is not made from materials dug out from the earth? Linen. Because linen we get from flax plant. Petrol, plastic, diesel. These materials we get from earth. By digging out the earth, we get these materials. So linen is the only material which we get from the plant. Okay. Next, where do we get these materials from? Rubber we get from rubber tree. Right. Cotton we get from cotton plant. Right. Cotton we get from cotton plant. Glass we get from sand. Petrol we get from petroleum, or you can say earth. By digging out the earth we get petroleum. So petrol we get from earth. From petroleum we make petrol, diesel, like these, okay. And plastics we get from petroleum. Now next chapter is birds and their bodies, chapter 6, okay. First, choose the correct option. First question, which of these birds cannot fly, children? Ostrich, parrot, sparrow, eagle. Which bird cannot fly? Yes, ostrich. Ostrich is the bird which cannot fly. Parrot, sparrow, eagle, these birds can fly. Ostrich is the bird which cannot fly. Right? Ostrich is the bird which cannot fly because the weight of the bird is very heavy. So it cannot fly. Although it has wings, but it cannot fly. Second, which of these are functions of feathers? Help the bird to fly, keep the bird warm, stop the bird from getting wet. So which of these are functions of feathers, children? Yes, all of these. Okay, all of these. feathers functions are, they help the bird to fly, they help the bird to keep their body warm, and they even stop bird from getting wet. So all of these functions are the functions of feathers. Third one, which of these feathers gives birds a shape? Which feather gives birds a shape, children? Flight feather, down feather, body feather, or all of these? Which of these feathers gives birds a shape? Yes, body feather is also known as contour feather. It gives shape to the bird. This kind of feather gives shape to the bird. Fourth, what kind of beak does a woodpecker have? What kind of beak does a woodpecker have? You know what woodpecker do? It just peck the tree, right? It just make a hole. From using his beak, he make a hole in that branch of a tree to find the insect. So what kind of beak does a woodpecker have? What kind of beak? Yes, sharp pointed beak, right? Sharp pointed beak, sharp pointed beak. Fifth, which of these birds has webbed feet? Which of these birds has webbed feet, children? Hen, sparrow, eagle, duck. Yes, duck has webbed feet. That means skins are joined. Because of the webbed feet, duck is able to swim, right? So, which of these bird has webbed feet? Duck, duck. Then, name the following. The feathers that help a bird to fly. Which feathers help a bird to fly? Yes. Flight feather. Which feather? Flight feather, right? Then, the feathers that keep a bird warm. The feathers that keep a bird warm. Which kind of feathers keep a bird warm, children? Which kind of feathers? Yes. Which kind of feathers? Down feathers. Down feathers helps them to keep their body warm. Third, feet where the toes are joined together by skin. Which kind of feet? Yes, webbed feet. Webbed feet in which the skins are joined together in between the toes. Okay, so feet where the toes are joined together by skin are webbed feet. Webbed feet. The sharp pointed claws of an eagle, that is known as talons. Talons, right? The sharp pointed claws of an eagle is talons. The talons are curved. So because of that curved claws, they easily can make a grip and they can easily hold a small animals in their talons. Okay. Now, name one bird that does the following. So scratch the ground. Which bird scratch the ground, children? Yes, hen or rooster. You can write hen or rooster. So, they are also known as scratching bird. Why do they do? They scratch the ground. They have very hard and sharp claws. Because of that, they scratch the ground. And why do they scratch? To find insect or seeds to eat. So, hen or rooster is a scratching bird. So, they scratch the ground. Wade through water. Which bird wade through water? Wade means walking on the water. Walking on the water. So, crane or heron wade through water. Crane or heron wade through water. They have very long and wide flat feet. Right? So, they easily wade on the water. Walk on the water. So, they are also known as wading birds. Third, climb trees. Which bird climb trees? Yes, woodpecker or parrot. Woodpecker or parrot. They climb trees. They have two pointed toes towards the front and two towards the back. So, they easily make a grip. Right? So, they are also known as climbing birds. They are also known as climbing birds. And not even they only climb. They can even hold a fruit using their claws. So, scratching birds are a rooster or hen. Wade through water, crane or heron, climb trees, woodpecker or parrot. Woodpecker or parrot. So, the revision is done, children, for these chapters. I hope it is more clear to you all now. Thank you, children. Sairam.